Hey, it's me, Tiffany. Welcome to my channel where I share all things pregnancy, postpartum, and motherhood related. I'm a certified birth and postpartum doula, so that means I support women and their families on their journey from conception to postpartum. If you haven't had a chance yet, please check out my website at www.nurturebytiff.com. So you can check out my doula services, you can check out my childbirth education courses, and you can check out my merch. Y'all forgive me. Any of y'all out there who have children, y'all know that, especially when they go to daycare and stuff like that, like they come home, they have germs, and my three-year-old has been sick for the past 2 days, and I feel like whatever it is she had, she's passed it to me, so I'm struggling. So if y'all hear me sounding congested or whatever, that's what it is. And it's also storming here, but I wanted to hop on here and give y'all this story real quick. So yesterday I brought y'all a story of a four-year-old girl that was missing here in the city of Memphis. I jumped on real quick and I shared the story. Unfortunately, the outcome was not a good one. So I'm going to share the update and come back and I'll talk about it.
Have you been able to find out about their arrest?
Greg, Memphis police say the couple lied about what happened here behind me. And as more details become available, heartbreak continues to set in for many across the city. After several hours of searching an uptown Memphis neighborhood Thursday for Sequoia Samuels,
officers located human remains in the 200 block of Caldwell Avenue.
Detectives found what is believed to be the body of a four-year-old girl at the center of a city watch.
My heart goes out to the community and our officers, those who spent so much time, you know, trying to find, you know, a little angel, if I can say that, you know, in our community.
Initially, Samuels was reported missing early Thursday morning. Court documents revealed that the child's mother, Brittany Jackson, initially lied to police about what really happened, but then told them a different story. She alleges that Samuels was physically attacked multiple times by her boyfriend, Jalen Hobson, weeks ago. At some point during the assault, the child became unresponsive, and he supposedly put her body in a garbage bag and stored it in the house for several weeks. The documents go on to say that the four-year-old remains were dumped in a garbage container within the apartment complex.
This last 24 hours has been a very somber time for the Memphis Police Department, and then this morning, very heartbreaking.
Following Samuel's death, MPD has charged Jackson with false reports, aggravated child neglect, and abuse of corpse. Hobson is only charged with false reporting as of now, leaving loved ones heartbroken.
I was through when this happened, but I'm gonna be okay because I know Corey in a better place.
WREG has learned last month that Hobson was charged in an unrelated case with a felony after he was found to be in possession of drugs and weapons while trespassing.
And I can tell you that MPD is stressing that they're still early in this investigation, so information could be fluid.
So that is where we are now. Yesterday, when the story first broke, I already felt like something was up. You know what I'm saying? It didn't sound right to me. Comes to find out, this baby had been gone for weeks, several weeks. The boyfriend, allegedly, I have to say allegedly, the boyfriend and the mother are being charged, but the boyfriend is the one who's responsible for her demise. And of course, as always, as these women do, they, you know, protect them or, you know, anyway, it's like these kids don't stand a chance, man. It's disgusting is what it is. Okay. This baby was, taken out. They put her in bags, like her remains were found and she was placed in a freaking dumpster. You know what I'm saying? And it's crazy because it was a family member. I'm not sure if it was the grandmother, aunt, whoever it was. They were talking about how when the baby, you know, when she was with her, you know, stayed with her and all that stuff, she never once gone to try to open no doors. You know, when they said that they woke up and the doors was just open or whatever, like, I just knew, you know what I'm saying, someone right. But I didn't touch on it yesterday. I was just trying to get the story out so people, you know, in the area or whatever knew what was going on and they could try to get out and search for this baby. But, like, what, I don't understand. I'm just not understanding. But yeah, the family member was saying that the baby had never once tried to leave. She also said that she had reported the mom before, but CPS never followed up. So if it ain't the parents, you know what I'm saying, who's doing a poor piss poor job, I guess I should say, of raising their children. Then when we try to get some help or get someone to intervene, CPS don't do what they supposed to do. It's like these babies can't win. They can't win. And I'm so freaking disgusted. Like, whatever they did to this baby, they need to get tenfold. Tenfold. Because what is this little 4-year-old going to do? And she was on a feeding tube. What the heck? Why? I don't understand why these women keep getting with these men and they allow these men to abuse their children. Like, what? How low is your self-esteem that you feel like that's the best you can do? I don't care if I offend anybody. How low is your self-esteem where you feel like that's the best you can do? Just to say that you with somebody. You gonna be with somebody that's gonna abuse your children? For real? And I'm pretty sure he may even have been abusing her, but golly. Like, come on. Everybody's not fit. I say this all the time. Everybody's not fit to be a parent. And this is a prime example. Like, there needs to be some changes. We need to have parenting classes. We need to make some changes. This is ridiculous. And my heart goes out to those who really did love and care about this baby. Because she did not deserve that. She did not deserve that at all. When the story broke, like, it hurt to hear. And I already knew in my soul that it was not going to come out like I wanted to come out. And here we are. But I just wanted to hop on here and give you an update as to what was going on. I thank you so much for watching. Comment, like, subscribe, share the story, and I'll catch you on the next one.